guys, Cheese here, and welcome to another episode of Ark Survival Evolved. How's everybody doing today? I'm having a great day today. We're back here on my beginners series, and today we're going to talk about upgrading the base. Now, we have our little wooden shack. It has done pretty well by us so far. It has kept us from getting killed. We have not gotten eaten, and all of our dinos and things are still intact. So far, it's been so good. But if you remember last episode, I don't know if he's still around over there, but we have a Spino that's living right over here somewhere. At least he was. I don't see him right now. Let's hope he's not there anymore and not just out of render distance. But anyway, it's time to upgrade the base to stone. So today's episode, we're going to talk about upgrading the base to stone, adding some more machinery in here, the next steps we should do for that. It should be a really interesting episode. Hopefully it'll help some new players out if you don't know how to already make a fabricator and upgrade your base and things like that. So if you guys enjoy this video, please do me a huge favor and flex on that like button. Yeah! And for more daily video game awesomeness, don't forget to subscribe. All right, so the first step in upgrading the base to stone is we're going to gather an absolute buttload of stone and wood. So we're going to use the Cheever and the Chodiek, and we're going to just completely gather up this whole area. So for me, I always like to gather a whole bunch of materials first and then build. Just seems to make it a lot easier than when you're, you know, you craft a couple walls and you don't have enough wood and you go get some more wood and you craft three more walls. And I don't like to do it that way. So we're going to just gather up a whole mess of materials. So we'll have all the materials, hopefully, that we'll need for the entire project. And then we'll be right back. And we're back, and I've harvested up most of the stone and trees in the area, as you can see. We have a whole bunch of stone, wood, and thatch. I made up a bunch of stone building pieces, so I went into my Ingrams. I scrolled down to where it got into the stone building pieces, which are about level 24. And learned basically almost all of those. I like to know all the different building pieces and whatnot. I'm using the S Plus crafting table. If you have S Plus, you're on PC. I'm just using this to craft in. It's the same thing as crafting it in your inventory. It's just like an extra crafting spot, and it crafts a little bit faster, and it holds more materials and whatnot. Before we go into upgrading the base, though, I just wanted to talk to you guys real quick in case you don't know. So we're going to be converting this wooden base into stone. Now, I could start picking up these pieces, but if you're playing on vanilla Ark and I pick up this foundation, let's say I destroy it because I wouldn't be able to pick it up, all of this would break. So that's not how you want to do it. You don't want to start by like breaking the bottom stuff if you're on vanilla. If you're on PC like I am with funny building rules, I don't need any support, as you can see. So if you're on PC and I'm on PC with S Plus and foundation support turned off, so I can do things like have floating walls and floating things that shouldn't happen normally in normal Ark. But if you're on normal Ark and I want to start converting this base into stone, what I would just take the stone foundation and place it right on top of the, oh, these are S Plus, so they're not working. Everything's gone wrong. Why isn't that working? Wait, can I just do it in here then? Yeah, okay. So I can line it up in here. For some reason, it's not working over there. But I'm just going to take the stone foundation and just place it right over the wooden foundation. It'll break the wooden foundation, give me half my materials back, just like it would if you broke it normally. But I don't have to pick up and replace all this stuff. So, like under my smithy here, I'm going to replace under my bed and my preserving bin, like all this stuff. I'm changing to stone. But I don't have to pick it up and remake my smithy, my forges, and like just redo everything. So that's a little building tip, if we can get all this junk out of the way, of how to start converting. And the same thing works with like walls and ceilings. So if I want to start converting these walls and I don't want the whole thing to fall down, I'll just convert this wall. Boom. Now that wall's stone. It breaks. It gives me half the materials back. But everything else still stays. It doesn't fall down. So I'm going to start I'm just gonna make a big box. I'm not gonna try to make anything super pretty at this point. I don't even think this will be our permanent living situation. This is just kind of where we spawned in. And typically in Ark, that's how it happens. You spawn in, you just start wherever you start, and then you start making a base and you try to survive. And eventually we're gonna move to some place that's prettier and nicer and some place we like better. So right now we're just gonna try to make a very utilitarian stone box that'll keep us and our dinos safe. So that's what we're looking for. I think I'm gonna go like 5x5. Oh, something's attacking. Please don't be a Spino. What is that? Compies, no big deal. And we're gonna pick up the turtle eggs because we still need these for kibble. Okay, so we're gonna start laying out a box here. And I'm just gonna kind of go around. I'm thinking 5x5 with maybe like a little hole in the middle just to make it somewhat sort of interesting. I'm having building issues. Perfect. Nailed it. Okay, this is... How many is this already? 1, 2, 3, 4. Can I get one more here? Let's go. 5. We've done it. And then we'll go this way is 1, 2, 3. Oh, we got to pick up this stuff. So we're on S plus again, so we can pick up all these things. If you're on vanilla Ark, you're going to have to just break it. And that stinks at the way that's the way it is, but that's just the way it is. You break it and you get half your materials back. And that's just kind of something you have to live with vanilla Ark. And part of the reason why, if you're on PC, you really should be playing S plus. It just makes the game better. Okay, so I'm just going to start filling this all in with foundations, and we'll be back in just a minute once I get it all basically laid out. And we're back, and this guy seems to enjoy our new house. At least he's... Hi, what's up, buddy? Yeah, so I made a box, like I said I was going to. It's a 5x5 box. I put double doors on each side and ramps so you can kind of run in. If I'm being chased by any direction, this is a dramatic reenactment. There's a T-Rex coming. Ah! Oh, God! I'm in the base. I'm safe. See, I'm good on that side. Dramatic reenactment on this side. Ah! There's a T-Rex coming. Oh, God! Oh, I forgot to place the ramp. No, the T-Rex eats me and I'm dead. Okay. Well, we need another ramp on this side. Dang it. Okay. So that's, little things as you're building. All right. So we need one more ramp on this side. But yeah, as I said, we made a 5x5 box. I took down the dodo pen that was on the back. They've gotten moved into the big house with us. And there we go. Dramatic reenactment. T-Rex. And we're in the base. So basically just doors on each side. I kind of moved things around a tiny bit in here. Basically just made some more room and I moved the dodos in the house. I still got to finish the walls, which is what I'm going to do now. I'm going to use window walls. It doesn't make any difference in heating or cooling or really anything to use window or not window, but I just like it for the extra light so that when you're in your base during the day you can actually see something and it's not all super dark all the time. So let's throw some windows around the outside here, and then we need to finish the roof, which I'm not super concerned about, to be honest. We're pretty much safe at this point in a too high stone. We're not completely safe. A T-Rex, an alpha T-Rex could come right now and just ruin our lives. But we're doing pretty good right now. We could leave a section of the roof open and just leave the Pteranodon in the base. I'm tempted. Or maybe on top. I'm not sure. But anyway, we're going to start getting into more machinery and more things that we can make now. We got another level. Let's put some more points into health. So if we scroll down to Fabricator, which starts unlocking right about, not exactly sure. There we go. Greenhouse stuff. We're going to have to get some crystals so we can get into greenhouse stuff for sure. Here we go. This is the line at level 48. You want what you want to unlock? Fabricator, polymer, electronics. We're going to unlock the S plus fabricator because we have S plus. And then hopefully, I'm not sure we're going to be able to make all this stuff. We're going to try. Generator, we're going to want straight pipe. We're going to use the S plus straight pipe, but if you don't have S plus, electrical outlet, we want to learn. And then industrial grill, we're going to learn. Just for, where's refrigerator? I would really like to make a refrigerator. Refrigerator, where are you at? We can make flak elm armor now. All right, we're just going to search for it because I can't find it. Refrigerator is at level 60, so we're gonna learn refrigerator, an S plus refrigerator. Okay, now in order to craft these, we have to go into our smithy. We have to go to structures, crafting, fabricator. I think we should have all the stuff we need to make it. We need metal. We really out of metal? Are you kidding me? No! Why? No! Alright, I have to do a metal run and I'll be right back. And we're back! And I harvested up and cooking a bunch of metal. I put the entire roof on, so now we're completely roofed. We've been roofed. Alright, let's see if we can go back to crafting things. So, into the S plus smithy, or the regular smithy, fabricator, pull, craft. Let's go. Now we have a fabricator. Oh, did I make any gasoline yet? I might not have made gasoline. Alright, the fabricator is pretty big. We're going to place this in. Little tip, if you guys don't know, when you're going to place this on keyboard and mouse, it's K. On console, I'm not exactly sure what it is, but there's like a free look button. But I get it kind of lined up like this, and then I push K, and then it allows me to see it. Now, if you crouch, it'll bring it closer to you. So further away, but crouch, it'll be closer. And then I can line it up with the wall. As I can see, it's a little bit turned wrong. So I go out of K mode, turn a little bit, back into K mode. Make sure it's lined up perfect and just where I want it, right on the turtle's head. And boom, fabricator, we've done it. Now, this is unpowered. This runs on gasoline or electricity if you have S+, but we're going to just say assume it runs on gasoline. We're going to need some gasoline, which means we need some oil. Do we have oil left? All right, I'm going to have to make up some gasoline. Did I not make any anywhere? Thought I had some gasoline somewhere from something. Gasoline. Well, I'm done. Damn it. Alright, I'm gonna need to find some oil and some hide, and I'll be right back. And we're back, and I was just being derpy. We did have oil. It's in the preserving bin, but it wouldn't pull from the preserving bin because it's making jerky, as you can see. So we're gonna take half the jerky from there. We have some hide in our inventory. Now, if you go over to a forge, and you put oil and hide into a forge, that starts crafting gasoline. It takes 5 hide and, what does it say? 5 hide and 6 oil to make 5 gasoline. It actually makes 5 each time. So that's pretty great. Now we have gasoline. Bring that over here to the fabricator and we'll be able to turn that on. Now, if we go on to electrical, the first thing we're going to need to make is a generator. Now, in order to make the generator, we need 25 metal ingots, which we know how to make, and 10 electronics. Now, electronics is actually made in the fabricator. If you go here all the way back out to the main menu, go into the fabricator, go to composites. It's right here. This is electronics. It takes 3 silica pearls and 1 metal ingot. So I think we have enough to pull for all that. Remember, silica pearls you can find in beaver dams or along the edges of water sometimes, or either that or you have to dive deep ocean for them. So here we go. As you can see, I pulled the things, but it won't craft yet. So if you've noticed, if you're like in the fabricator and you're like, I can't get it, it won't craft, that's because it's not turned on. So once I turn it on now, boom, now I can craft 10 electronics. And it'll craft up quite quickly. We'll go back in here to electrical, go to our generator, pull 25 metal. And now we have 10 electronics, 25 metal ingots, and craft. We have a generator. Let's go. Now this is going to allow us to power or supply electricity to other things around the base. Now the first thing we're going to put in is a refrigerator. Now a refrigerator is basically like a preserving bin where it preserves your things and makes them last longer. But it makes it last way, way longer than with a preserving bin, so which is really great. So we placed our generator down. Now we need to run power out of the generator into other things. So we're going to need some wires to do that. So back into the fabricator, go into electrical. We're going to make one straight pipe here, one straight cable, I mean, which is only 2 metal. And we're going to make one outlet, which we need. Oh, we need 3 more electronics to make the outlet. So back into the composites, we're going to pull for 3 electronics. It's a bit of a rabbit hole crafting once you get to the higher levels of things. Okay, now to the, let's make one outlet, and there we go. That's going to be everything we need to run power out of the generator. So here we go. We take our straight pipe, and it'll show us, see the light little bit of green line? That's going to show us where it's going to place. So ours, we're just going to go right there. We're going to place the outlet on the end, and then we're going to take some gasoline. And we're going to put gasoline in the generator. And we're going to turn it on. Boom, we have power. It's lit up. As you can see, it lights up, and we now have power. This is sparking down here. You can tell you're getting power to here. But now, but wait, there's more. It's like a ShamWow commercial. Now we need something for it to run. So in order for a refrigerator, which I really want, we need 25 crystal, 10 electronics, 120 metal ingots. Wow, and polymer. I'm not sure I gathered enough metal. I might have to go gather more metal. Do I... And I'm not sure I have enough for the electronics either. No, I don't have enough. All right, so I have to go get more silica pearls and more metal. But in the end, we're going to have a super cool and functioning base. But I'll be right back. And we're back. And after more beaver dam stealing metal cooking and trilobite harvesting, we're back. We should have enough to make now our refrigerator. So let's pull. We need the electronics to make. Never mind. Composite, let's make the electronics first. We need the 10 electronics necessary. Make those. Then go to an electronics. Pull on the refrigerator. Bam, let's go. We're refrigerating. Okay. Now, when you go to place these down, it just needs to be within a close enough range to this outlet, and it'll wire up automatically. So if I just place it like here, boom. Like, it's powered. It just wires automatically. But I'm not going to put it there because it looks ridiculous. I think I'll probably... So on S Plus as well, if you walk up to the outlet and hold for more options, you can disable the sparks, which makes it a lot nicer. And then you can hide it, which is nice. And then you can also hide nearby wires. And if you go to this, to the generator, you can hide wires as well. So all that stuff is still there, but you don't have to look at the ugliness of it. So if you're running wires all over your base and you have S Plus, definitely recommend you do that. So here we go. We're going to line up the refrigerator. Probably going to put two of these over here eventually. So we're just going to line it up pretty close. We're going to kneel down. We're going to go into K mode here. See how we're looking. It's actually pretty darn good. Boom. We've done it. We have our very first refrigerator, which is really great. So now we're going to take all of our things from our preserving bin, except we're going to leave the oil, the spark powder, and the meat to continue making jerky. The cooked meat went onto my stack. There it is. I'm like, where did it go? So we're going to leave this in here. This can continue making jerky for us. Eventually, we need to get on to making prime meat jerky. But let's see. So this citronol right here in the preserving bin lasts 4 hours. In my inventory, last 28 minutes, but in the refrigerator, I don't even know what that is. 2 years? Two, that's hours, days, and months, maybe? Long time, really long time. It adds a huge amount of spoil time onto absolutely everything, so that's really great. So awesome, the inside of the base is really coming along, and we can really, really... keep a lot better track of our stuff. Our vegetables can stay longer. Our kibble will last like forever now. 594 days, I think that's gonna last, which is super great. But now we need to work a little bit on base defense. So I started making, now this is probably not the prettiest or most amazing looking, or this isn't gonna make your neighbors jealous of how cool your base looks, way to defend your base. But if you just want a base that doesn't have Spinos walking up and biting on it, here's what I'm going to suggest. We're going to make up stone gateways. I made up 30 S plus stone gateways, and I'm going to just kind of make a fence of them around my base. Now, it gets a little bit tricky on the upsies and downsies, little hilly areas. I'm going to start here. I don't care about protecting this as well. If something wants to come over and attack my little garden, that's okay. So I'm not worried about boxing that in with me. I basically want my dinos in my base safe. So we're going to go boom. If you're super anal about things being straight, you can lay the whole thing out on fence foundations. But again, for me, this is a starter base. This is a utilitarian base. This is where I can lay my head at night and not have to worry about a Spino chewing on my face. It's basically all it is for me. It's not going to be the most beautiful thing. Later on, I'll find a really amazing waterfall or cliff or make some like really cool and interesting base, but we're not at that point yet. We're just still trying to survive the arc. We're trying to tame some dinos that are actually tough. We're just in the beginning, so I'm just gonna make it ugly and useful, which was also my nickname in high school, and it's gonna be great, and it's gonna be safe. And I'm not gonna bother putting in actual doorways or gates in here, because the little things that can get through, like raptors or terror birds or things around this area, shouldn't cause me too much trouble. Now, if an alpha raptor were to get in here, that could be huge, huge problems. But sometimes you roll the dice, and for the sake of materials used, we're just gonna line it up like this, and we're gonna leave the doors open and hope that we're okay. How are we doing? We're still doing good on gate frames. I think I'm able to make it all the way around here. Now, another thing, a tip here, if you're trying to line these up, and I'm just kind of doing it, but if you want to get super, you want them super straight and everything, you can always go into K mode and kneel down so it's closer and get it all super lined up, really, you know. But I'm just trying to do it quick and relatively painless for the video. So we're just kind of slapping them down, but you can definitely take your time, get these absolutely perfect if you want. But for me, we're just trying to survive right now. Later on, we'll make something beautiful and amazing and make the neighbors jealous kind of base, but we're not there yet. All right, we're almost around. The hard part for me is always kind of trying to make these two ends match up nicely, not look terrible. So we're going to try to get these to match up here, not be awful, maybe. No, I don't want that. We're kind of close. This hill's kind of getting yucky. It's not too bad, actually. If we pick this one up, we can kind of probably fix it pretty good. And nope. All right, let's pick this one up, fix it a little bit. Come on, man. You're embarrassing me in front of my friends. All right, here we go. Boom, let's go. We've done it. We've got the amazing, most protected, safest base of all time. All right, none of that's true. But at least it's a little bit safer. I don't have to worry about a Spino getting in and just destroying everything I've worked for. Although, I should have built it a little bit further away from the base. And we'll probably work on that. We still have 8 more gate frames, so maybe we'll move it out a little bit more just to give us a little bit of... You know what? It's this corner right here. We're going to pick these up. I feel like we need to come out a little bit. It's a little cramped on that side. I don't like that. We want the dinos, because the dino is going to be able to run right up to this fence. We don't want it to be able to bite it, like our dinos through the gap we're giving it. So let's move those out a little bit. Let's make it a little bit better. Should be more like this, I feel like. Can we... Yep, not bad. All right, hopefully we can close the gap with these two, maybe. Can we do it? Can we do the thing? Bam. And... Well, it looks like we... Maybe. Did we do it? Perfect. We did it! All right, I like that a lot better. It gives us a little bit more breathing room. If I'm a T-Rex and I'm right here and I'm trying to bite the base, I'm like, yeah, 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 I can't, I want it, yeah, yeah, I want to eat that base so bad, but I just can't reach. Yeah, that's better. But that's about all the time we had for today, guys. We talked about how to upgrade your base to stone, how to make a fabricator, how to make a generator and your first refrigerator, and how to make your base a little bit safer with kind of a janky, quickly made fence. As you can see, after I crafted the parts, how long did that take me to make? 2-3 minutes? So a quick and safe base, but that's all the time we have. So if you guys liked this video or you learned anything today, please do me a huge favor and flex on that like button here. Or for more daily video game awesomeness, don't forget to subscribe. And if you guys are looking for your own ARK server like the one I use, make sure to check out my Nitrado link down below. They have really great servers and really great prices and excellent customer service. I definitely recommend them to anybody that needs their own server. And if you guys haven't come and seen me live, I stream live on Twitch every single day. Lots of ARK and Fortnite and Minecraft and other stuff. lots of fun things. I'd love to meet you guys and chat and hang out. You should come see me at twitch.tv/RoyaleWithCheeseTV. But before we go, we got to go say goodbye to Murder. Hey, Murder, what's up, man? Yo, Murder, what's up, man? Hey, what's going on, man? Not too much. We upgraded the base to stone. Yeah, it looks really good. Hey, thanks, man. Look at me when I'm talking to you. Look at me! We upgraded the base to stone. We made a new refrigerator and a fabricator and a generator, all sorts of cool stuff. What's up with you, man?
Not too much. Hey, what did Yoda say when he first saw himself on Blu-ray?
I don't know. What?
HDMI. Get it? HDMI? Like Yoda talks?
That was a pretty bad one, but also topical, because there's a Fortnite Star Wars event today that I'm going to be doing later on, but that's all the time we have. I love you guys. I'll see you guys next time. Cheese and a newly awesome stone base with a refrigerator out.